in the next exercise 14.2. Now that is the slope. Now what is the meaning of slope? Now every line makes some angle with x-axis and y-axis. See, if I draw the graph like this one, on here there is this line is. Now this line makes some angle with y, any angle with x. Now inclination means we will take the angle only with x-axis, not with y-axis. We will take the angle always with x-axis. Then this is the angle theta. If I want to find the slope, now what is the meaning of slope? Slope means this angle with tan, that means tan theta become the slope. Theta inclination with x-axis and the value of that angle with tan in the table of tan, that become the slope of that line. That means tan theta we represented with m. This is our slope. Then next point is parallel lines or perpendicular lines. We know that parallel lines at the equal distance, like this one, this is one line, another line, they have always at equal distance. If this is 2 2 2 2 2, every time it will same distance, that are called the parallel line. Now parallel line never meets to one another, never intersect. Now these parallel line, then suppose I see it on the x-axis, because I know that the angle with the x-axis, this angle and this angle parallel line, these angles will be equal. That means in the case of parallel lines, slope always will be equal. But in case of perpendicular lines, this is one and another one is this one. These two lines are perpendicular. This is the line 1, this is the line 2. Then what is there? If the slope of this one, line 1, is m, then the perpendicular line have the slope reciprocal and negative of it. It means its slope will be minus 1 upon m. First line have the slope m, I suppose it. Then the second line have, that is perpendicular to the first line, its slope will be negative and reciprocal of it. In the case of perpendicular, we can check it by the slope of first line and the slope of second line. The answer become minus 1. That means if the lines are perpendicular, the product of the slopes of two line will be minus 1. Clear? Then in the next, two concepts are there. One is parallel line and other one is the perpendicular line, and we use in these cases slope, that is value of tan theta and angle always with x-axis. These are the main concepts. If you grasp it now, then you can do this exercise very easily. Now see in the exercise, first exercise, first sum, to find the slope, angles are given, we find the tan, that means 0 degree. Tan 0 degree, that answer become 0. If the value is given 72 degree and 30 minutes, that means we will use the tangent table that given in below at the back of your book. I already explained you. Then in the next inclination, we have to find the inclination. The value is given. Now value, that means tan theta, that is given under root 3. Now the in the table, tan under root 3 is the value of tan 60 degree. That means this theta value is 60 degree. Inclination will be 60 degree. In next sum, now I have to find the slope. If the angle is given, that is too much easy, I find the value of tan, that angle, that become the slope. But now if the points are given, two points are given, and I have to find the slope of that given points, become a line. Now suppose this point and this point, two points are given, and the first point is minus 3 minus 2 and minus 3, and the second point is given 1 and 2. These two points are given, and I suppose this line like this one. Now I want to find the slope of this line. Then how to find? See this formula. This value become x1, this value become y1. This become x2, this become y2. Now if the two points are given, see students, I am again repeating, if the angle is given, just tan angle, that become the slope. But two points are given, because there are three concepts. then we have to understand. If the two points are given, then how to find the slope? The formula of slope is y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. That means I have to put the value from the given points, then it becomes the slope of that line. Now the value of y2 is 2, then the value of y1 is minus 3. We have to take the negative also. Next concept, x2. x2 is given 1, then the x1 is given minus 2. Then it becomes 2 plus 3, 1 plus 2. The answer becomes 5 upon 3. It becomes given points, then I will use the formula. That formula put the value and that becomes the slope of that line. If the two points are given, then we use this formula. In next, these are the given parallel line. Now two points are given and I want to find the parallel line slope. That means same way I will use the slope. I know parallel line have the same slope. That answer becomes same. In the next, we have to find the slope of the perpendicular line. Now see, the point is given, sum number 5. Point is given 0, 5 at minus 2, 4. This is the given points. And I want to find the slope that is perpendicular to it. Now first I find the formula y2 minus y1, x2 minus x1. Again put the value, what is x1, y1, x2, y2. Now put 4, then plus 5, then minus 2 plus 0. Then it becomes 9 upon minus 2. This is the slope of the given line. But I want to find the perpendicular line. What to do? Take the negative and reciprocal. That means it becomes the value of n. I take minus 1 upon n. Now minus already there. But in our answer, there is also negative. I have to take the reciprocal. Numerator and denominator will be interchange. It becomes minus 2 upon 9. It means my now perpendicular line have the slope 2 upon 9. Once again, if perpendicular, take the negative reciprocal. If parallel, take the same one. In next sums, then 8, 9, there are few points are given and we have to see it is a parallelogram, it is a right angle triangle. Now see right angle, we don't want to use the distance formula because it belongs to equation of line. Then what to do? We have to just see perpendicular. Perpendicular, that means I will check the slope. That means I will take the slope of three lines. If the slope, one slope and another slope is reciprocal and negative, that means two lines are perpendicular. If the two lines are perpendicular, that means triangle is a right angle. If I want to check the parallelogram, then four points are given. I make the four line CD and DA. Then I will take the four slopes. Again use the same formula. If the two slopes are same, that means two lines are parallel. It belongs to a parallelogram. Just two formulas are there. Remember it, parallel and perpendicular. In the case of parallel, take the same slope. In the case of perpendicular, take the negative and reciprocal. Now there is a given figure. I want to just share it. Sum number 13. That is given. There is given y-axis. Then there is given x-axis. This is our origin point. And there is a given triangle like this one. Now this is parallel line. Now see, I already explained this line angle make with x-axis. Now x-axis have no angle with it because lie on the line. It means its angle will be 0 degree. Now AB is parallel to this x-axis. Then the angle of AB will be also 0. And the slope of AB will be 10, 0, that becomes 0. Then he said to find the ABC parallel x, find the slope of all sides. I want to find the all slopes. And this is an equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle, that means makes the angle of all angles will be 60 degree. AB I already find. Now I want to find this one, AC. Slope of AC. Now what? X-axis, this line parallel. If this angle is 60, with x-axis also 60, that means I will find the angle of 10, 60 degree. That becomes square root 3. In case of BC, now see students, this is the positive side. This is the negative side. That must become 120. We have to take the angle with positive x-axis. inside there is 16. We know it is a linear pair, outside there will be 120. Now I have to find the angle of tan 120. Then this concept, you don't know the value of, we know the value is up to 90 degree. Now what to do? It is the negative side. That means value of tan, you become 90 plus 30. 120 become 90 plus 30. This is the negative side. You can take, otherwise if there is negative side, you can take the value of negative of that side. Just easy. If in the angle with the negative side, we can take the value with sign of negative. Okay? In the next exercise, third exercise, there is the points of x intercept and y intercept. Now what is the meaning of x and y intercept? I draw a line, it cut on the some point on x axis, any point on the y axis. Where it cut x axis, that is called x intercept, and where it cut y axis, it is called y intercept. Clear? X intercept means cut at the x axis, y intercept means cut at the y axis. Then there we have to prepare the equation of line. There is a one general equation. Now that is, what is that? General equation for the equation of line y equals to mx plus c. Now y is a variable, x is a variable. What is the meaning of this m and what is the meaning of this c? This m, m is the slope of the line. That means tan theta. And this c, that is called y intercept. Where the line cut the y axis, that is called the value of c. Then in your exercise, we have two points are given, and we have to now prepare the equation of line also. Then how to prepare it? The formula that is y minus y1 equals to m x minus x1. This is the formula to prepare the equation of the line if the two points are given and we have to just find the slope. Now we will prepare the equation of line from two given points. Now in your 14c, y intercept is given, slope is given. That is simple one. Y intercept, that means value of c, that is given 2, and the slope, that is value of m is given. We have to prepare it. Value is mx plus c. Value of m is 3. Value of c is 2. This is my equation of line. Simply we have to put the value of c and the value of m. When the next sums, the two points are given and I have to prepare, and I have to just clear about the equation of line. How to prepare it? We will use this one. Now see sum. Sum number, we can see 6 sum. The coordinates of the two point P and Q are given, gradient. Now new word is gradient. Gradient is nothing new. That is also slope. That is the other name of the slope. If gradient is written, you can see it as a slope. That means tan theta or y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. In this sum, we first find the gradient of PQ. P is given 2 and 6. This value is given. Then the Q value is given, that is given minus 3 and 5. First we want to find the slope. That means slope will be y2 minus y1, then x2 minus x1. It becomes minus, that means my slope is 1 upon 5. In the next part, he said to find the equation. Now PQ, I take it as x1, y1. It takes x2, y2. Now the slope line of equation will be y minus y1 and x minus x1. Now the value of y, y is the variable, don't take it. Just we will put the value of y1 and x1 and m. X and y remain same because that our variable in the present in the equation of line. Now y minus y1 is 6. Then m is 1 upon 5. X minus x1, that is 2. Now I have to solve it. It becomes 5y minus 30 x minus 2. Now 5y minus 30 plus 2 equals to x. X then minus 5y this become positive minus 28. This is my line of equation. That means if the two points are given, first I find the slope, then I use this equation of line and put the value of x and y1, then I can find the value of equation of line. Then see the sum number 10. The following figure, now figure is given. In this figure, there is a given parallelogram. In this parallelogram, AB line is parallel. And there is a given angle of 60 degrees. Then another point C is given, 7 and 5. Now see, parallel line is given. And he say to find the equation of BC. First I want to find the value of BC. Parallel line there will be also 60. First I find the slope, 10, 60, that become under root 3. Now I want to find the equation of line. One passing point is given. Just we find the formula y minus y1 and x minus x1. Now y minus y1 is given 5. Then m I find under root 3, x minus x1 7. That is my equation. I will just open it and we can take the variable on the one side. In this exercise, we use this equation of line. If the two points are given, first find the slope, then use the formula. And in your 14D exercise, see students, in this exercise, you can see there is a mixer of the already done. We use the midpoint formula, we use the line of equation, we use the formula of slope, and we can solve it. But in the first, there is something different that I will want to solve. All sums are same. Don't worry about the figures. See, in this sum, first I given y equals to 4. Now there is not given x, but I have the general equation y equals to mx plus c. Now x is not given, that means the coefficient of x will be 0. My slope is 0 and y intercept is 4. If the x is present, variable is present, that means slope is present, otherwise slope will be 0. In next sums, perpendicular condition, parallel condition, you can use it. Just remember the formulas. Again, I am repeating. First formula related to slope. Y2 minus Y1 upon X2 minus X1 if two points are given. If angle is given, then we find the slope by tan theta. If two points are given and I have to prepare the line of equation. First, I find the slope. M equals to Y2 minus Y1, X2 minus X1. And the slope, then the line of equation is y minus y1 equals to m x minus x1. Just use this formula and you can solve it. In